The Experiential Robotics Platform, or XRP, is a hands-on comprehensive robot platform for STEM education, summer camps, projects, and so much more. The XRP has been in a beta phase for the last couple years, but today we are finally coming out of beta with the official launch of the XRP.
Woohoo!
The XRP is more than just a robot. We do have a hardware kit available for sale, and there are significant upgrades over the beta version, which I'll talk about later. But the hardware is just one of four main components of the XRP. The second is the programming environment and library support to write code for the XRP in multiple programming languages, including Blockly, MicroPython, WPILib support for FIRST Robotics teams, Arduino compatibility, and more. For educators, the third component is online instructional modules created by Worcester Polytechnic Institute and summer camp guides presented by FIRST to help teach STEM topics using the XRP. And if you ever need help, the fourth component is online technical support forums to get assistance as needed. There's an entire consortium of partners behind the XRP. It's not just SparkFun. All of them have made their own unique contributions to bring this amazing platform to reality. The XRP is designed to be a powerful and expansive hands-on robotics platform. While costing less than a textbook, there is a significant discount for educators and FIRST Robotics teams, by the way, and being very easy to use. The base hardware kit can be assembled in just a few minutes with zero tools required, and so much can be taught and done with just the base kit. For example, learning how to control actuators like motors and servos, measuring and processing data from sensors, including the ultrasonic and line sensors, encoders, and the built-in IMU, learning math concepts like geometry, trigonometry, or even calculus, learning how to implement PID control, remote control, and IoT projects. There's even a spot for a whiteboard marker so you can program your XRP to draw fun pictures. During the beta phase of the XRP, we've seen adoption all over the world. Teachers are using the XRP in classrooms to teach STEM topics like programming, CAD, 3D printing, electronics, and more. Organizations and clubs are using the XRP for summer camps and other activities to help spread STEM in their local communities and get people excited about robotics. Universities like Worcester Polytechnic Institute, Cornell University, and University of Idaho are using the XRP for courses at the college level. The state of New Hampshire put XRP into every middle and high school in the state. XRPs were also given to every team competing in the first global challenge to help spread STEM within their countries. Speaking of which, the XRP can also serve as a bridge to FIRST Robotics programs by helping students learn the fundamentals of robotics and building their skills before diving into competitive robotics. FIRST Robotics teams are using the XRP to recruit new members at outreach events, train new software members using WPILib, and test ideas before implementing them on their competition robots. Those are just a handful of examples of what can be done with the base kit, but that is not the end of the XRP. Oh no, that is just the beginning. The XRP is designed for expansion and modification, so you can continue to reuse the XRP for new and creative projects. The rails around the perimeter of the chassis allow you to design and attach your own creations to expand your XRP's functionality. Additional electronics can be connected to the control board, such as more motors, servos, sensors, peripherals, coprocessors, or even custom circuits that you design and build. The entire XRP is open source, so you can take existing designs and modify them for your own needs. And the wide range of software compatibility will help you make your projects come to life. We've seen lots of creative modifications and expansions to the XRP from community members and from the 3D printing challenge we ran last summer, where we received over 100 submissions. For example, people have implemented fun and creative ways of driving the XRP, such as tank treads, mechanism drive, three-wheel omni-drive, swerve drive, front-wheel steering, a legged strider, a hexapod walker, a balance bot, or even a boat mod. People have also made fun attachments and add-ons like arms and grippers, a retractable pen holder, a forklift, a dump truck, excavator attachments, a big mouth with googly eyes, a Nerf crossbow, a ball launcher, a catapult, a vacuum cleaner, a rotating sonar, solar panels, and LED underglow. In addition to the projects from the community, some of the XRP consortium partners have also made their own incredible contributions. For example, our partner DigiKey has documented several of their XRP projects, like adding voice recognition to the XRP, adding a Google Coral to do camera-based object detection, implementing wireless charging with lithium batteries, adding a Raspberry Pi 5 as a coprocessor for various applications. They even 3D printed an XRP at 500% scale. Our partner group from Cornell University has completely reimagined various aspects of the XRP. They've created their own design of the chassis with a modified rail system that has its own unique advantages, overhead awning platform with Lego studs and snap bolt connectors, a mini chassis with a much smaller footprint, an overhead tracking and navigation system using April tags. They've added a Raspberry Pi Zero coprocessor to create an emotive display that gives the XRP much more character, vision capabilities, and other features. They've used the XRP to create a functional BB-8 robot. And they made this adorable robot with the XRP that went on a zero-G test flight in preparation for their next project of sending the XRP into space. Our partners at Cornell University and the University of Idaho are creating an agricultural XRP to teach industrial automation. It uses a gantry system to automatically tend to plants as an introduction to more industrial robotics. There's just so many ways of using the XRP, I wish I had time to show off everything. That is just a brief summary of what the XRP is and what it can do. Hopefully you can see this is not just a little robot, it really is a comprehensive robot platform for STEM education, amazing projects, and so much more. Now we will cover the contents of the hardware kit, major features, and upgrades over the beta. The base hardware kit comes with everything you see here. It includes the 3D printed chassis and plastics, the main control board, two drive motors with built-in encoders, a servo arm for picking up things, an ultrasonic distance sensor, a line following sensor, battery holder, and other hardware to fully assemble the robot. Note that AA batteries and a USB cable are required for use, but are not included in the kit. We do have cables and rechargeable AAs on our storefront if you need them. We also have some other kits available for sale. There is the DIY kit, which includes everything in the base kit except for the 3D printed plastics. So you can print it yourself in fun colors, customize the design, or make something else entirely. Both the base kit and the DIY kits come in larger sets if you need more of them. Those kits come with this awesome box for each XRP, which can be used to store the kit while not in use. For even larger deployments, we offer the parts kit, which is basically an even larger set of DIY kits that also omits the boxes. We've seen this used during the beta by New Hampshire's deployment of XRPs in every middle school and high school, for example, where they had local schools running their own print farms operated by students to give them real-world manufacturing experiences and packaging the kits into custom-branded boxes. In addition to all the kits, we of course also have all the individual parts on our storefront if you need replacements or more for bigger projects. Now let's take a look at the control board in more detail, which has been significantly upgraded since the beta. The new board is the same form factor as the beta board, meaning it's a drop-in replacement for users with the beta XRP. Though be aware, there are new pins poking through the back that may interfere with the support bar in the beta chassis, so you may need to modify your chassis to accommodate the new board. No longer is there the Raspberry Pi Pico W with RP2040 as a module. Instead, the new board implements the same circuitry as the Pico W, which enabled us to make some dramatic improvements. We've upgraded to the Raspberry Pi RP2350B, which includes a dual-core processor running at 150 MHz. It has roughly twice the performance and SRAM as the RP2040 on the beta XRP control board. The RP2350B also has 18 more GPIO pins, so 48 GPIO total. We've upgraded to 16 megabytes of flash memory, which is 8 times more than the beta control board, so you can store a lot more code and bigger files. We've also added 8 megabytes of PS RAM, meaning there's about 30 times more total RAM on the new board as the beta, enabling computation of large datasets like images. Wireless connectivity is enabled by the Raspberry Pi RM2 radio module, which is basically the top third of a Pico W, so you get the same 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi and Bluetooth radio for wireless connectivity. This enables things like remote control of the XRP and IoT projects. The USB connector has been upgraded to USB-C. Heads up to beta users that you'll need a new cable if you're going to upgrade the control board. Moving outwards, there are 4 motor connectors, each of which also include pins for motor encoders. The motor drivers have been upgraded to the Texas Instruments DRV8411A, which can measure the current consumed by each motor. This enables features like current limiting and torque control. There are 4 servo headers, twice as many as the beta control board, which enable more advanced mechanisms to be added to the XRP. Power to the control board is provided through the barrel connector, the same as the beta control board. Power typically comes from 4 AA batteries, but any power supply up to 11 volts is supported. Power can also be provided through the USB-C connector, but is limited to less current than the barrel connector. The power switch and buttons have been moved to a single cluster in the bottom right of the control board. This makes the power switch easier to access when it's in the chassis, and means you don't have to search the board to find the right buttons like on the beta control board. There are several LEDs on the board. Next to the USB connector is the red system LED, which indicates whether the processors, sensors, and peripherals are powered. Also, the red motor LED indicates whether the motors and servos have power. Note that the power switch must be in the on position for the actuators to actually receive power. There is a new low voltage indicator to give an early brownout warning. Note that this is not a low battery indicator, but if you're using four AA batteries, it coincidentally starts illuminating when the batteries are low, depending on the battery chemistry. There is the monochrome status LED that is user controllable, which is the same as the beta board, but has been changed from green to blue. And finally, there is a new RGB LED that you can set to be any color you like. It's a WS2812B addressable LED, the same as NeoPixels, and compatible LED strips can be chained off of its output. The board also includes a 6-degree of freedom IMU, or inertial measurement unit, the ST Microelectronics LSM60SOX. It includes a 3-axis accelerometer and 3-axis gyroscope, which can be used for accurate turning and advanced navigation applications. Along the top of the board are the 4 expansion connectors. The outer two are intended for the ultrasonic and line sensors to connect, though you can use them for other applications if you want. There's the same quick connector as the beta, labeled Quick Zero, which enables you to connect I2C devices, such as our vast catalog of quick devices. There's now a second quick connector, labeled Quick One, that replaces the extra connector from the beta control board, which is an entirely separate I2C bus. The IMU is connected to the Quick One bus and needs to be pulled very frequently, so we suggest you default to using the Quick Zero connector, but that second quick connector is there if you need it. Finally, there are the new expansion headers. These 4 rows of 20-pin, 0.1-inch headers provide easy access to many of the electrical signals, including most of the GPIO pins, the power rails, and other control signals. This enables you to easily add more electronics to the XRP than the beta control board, such as add-on boards or custom circuits with breadboards and jumper wires. The inner 2 rows are almost identical to the Raspberry Pi Pico footprint and pinout. The only difference is that different GPIO pins are used for the ADC pins, since the RP2350B uses different GPIO pins for the ADC. This identical footprint means you can easily plug in existing add-on boards designed for the Raspberry Pi ecosystem, such as this display board from Pi Moroni. Be aware that many of these add-on boards are designed to go on the bottom of a Pico with male headers, whereas the XRP has female headers on top. To ensure those add-on boards can be used with the XRP, we created the Pico add-on flipper, which flips the header rows and genders so those add-on boards can be used with the XRP. The outer 2 rows of headers provide access to additional GPIO pins, XRP-specific power rails, and XRP-specific control signals. Be aware that most of the 48 GPIO pins have some default usage on the XRP, such as controlling the actuators or interfacing with sensors. However, 8 of the GPIO, specifically 12 through 19, have been reserved exclusively for the user, with almost all functions available, meaning you can use them for any purpose you like. If you need more GPIO or different GPIO, you will have to trade their default XRP usage. For example, if you use one of the GPIO that interfaces with one of the motors, you will no longer be able to use the corresponding motor connector. This is likely to occur if you're using third-party Pico add-on boards, so check which GPIO pins they use to see which features of the XRP you might have to trade. That is all the major features of the control board. Now let's talk about the 3D printed plastics. These have been significantly upgraded since the beta while maintaining the same general design and features. For users with the beta XRP, the new plastics are backwards compatible with the other components in the kit, so you can purchase or 3D print the new plastics yourself to keep using the other hardware. The 3D printed plastics include the chassis, the battery retention clip, mounts for the sensors, the mount for the servo, the lifting arm, and the drive wheels. The chassis connects everything together. It has an integrated compartments and mounts for the control board, the battery holder, drive motors, and caster wheels. It even has a holder for a whiteboard marker, so you can have the XRP draw pictures on a whiteboard. The rails around the perimeter are used to add clip-on attachments for the XRP, including the servo and sensors, but also any attachments that you create. Since the beta, notches have been added to the bottom of the rails, so clips designed with corresponding nubs can be easily aligned and won't slide around, such as on the new line sensor mount. Hexagonal holes have been added to the rails as another attachment option. You can design corresponding hexagonal pins to keep attachments positioned and oriented correctly. Alternatively, the holes are sized such that M4 bolts can be threaded into the holes if you prefer to bolt things down instead of clip them on. There are also holes aligned with the motor shafts, so long axles can be attached to power something other than the normal drive wheels, like the Balance Bot and Strider XRP shown earlier. Cable management bars have been added since the beta design to help keep your wiring more organized. You can wrap wires and cables around them to take up slack, so they're less prone to getting caught or snagged on something. The battery holder has been redesigned. Now there's a simplified retention bar that keeps the batteries from falling out and is much more durable than the beta design. There are also bumps in the compartment that grab the battery holder and ensure it doesn't fall out when the retention bar is removed while swapping out batteries. The design has also been optimized for 3D printing. Ramped sections have been added for overhanging features, and bridges are integrated into the design so less support material is needed. In fact, there's only one piece of support material required for the whole print, which is designed into the model so it breaks off easily. The durability has also been improved in multiple ways. The battery holder has been redesigned as mentioned before, all the clips and mounts have been improved, and the caster wheel cages are thicker, and we are now having these manufactured by our partner 3D Printing Nerd using higher quality 3D printers and filament than the beta. All of this contributes to a more durable XRP. That's it for the 3D printed plastics. Now let's talk about the rest of the hardware in the kit. Each kit comes with two motors to drive the XRP. Each has built-in encoders to measure how far it rotates. Cables are also included to connect to the control board, along with rubber O-rings that go over the 3D printed wheels for traction. Caster wheels are also included to support the front end of the chassis. One servo is included to rotate the 3D printed arm. It includes a few different servo horns, and the arm attaches to the servo with one of these. Note that screws are included if you want to securely attach the arm, although you can also get away without these screws for a truly tool-free assembly of the XRP. The ultrasonic distance sensor measures the distance to an object in front of it using sound. Note that it works best with flat and hard surfaces. Also worth noting, this got an upgrade since the beta by flipping the headers around so they no longer protrude above the chassis, allowing you to flip over the assembled XRP without damaging the wires. The line sensor measures the lateral position of a line underneath it for line following projects. It uses two infrared LEDs and analog light sensors to detect the edges of a line with a high contrast background. Cables are included for the sensors, as well as the battery holder. You will need four AA batteries, which are not included in the kit. We have these on our storefront if you need them, and I personally recommend nickel metal hydride batteries since they're rechargeable. You will also need a USB-C cable, which is not included in the kit. Note for beta users that this is changed from the micro B connector on the beta XRP control board. So, that is the XRP. The base kit is jam-packed with features, and there are countless ways of expanding the platform to do amazing things. We cannot wait to see how this platform continues to evolve, and we hope you are just as excited about it as we are. Also, quick thank you to all of our partners again. This platform would not have come to reality without their help, so massive thank you to all of them. That's the XRP. Get yours on our website, and as always, stay safe, be kind, and happy roboting. All right, I'm ready to botch this several times. The XRP or Experiential... No, other way around. Far so much... Far too much? I was going to say far too much.